Hello, Twitch. Let me go ahead and tweet this out. What's going on here? I have notifications. What? I'll look at that later. All right. I am about to go into battle with, I believe, Malik. So I want to go ahead and give it a few minutes still. And, take care of some stuff right quick. Like, I've been drinking soda all day, so it's probably not a good thing. So I'll go ahead and, go more live on the internet here in just a few minutes. Just bear with me. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Let's do this. Let's go ahead and do this and this. I'm at 37 hours, 46 minutes on this playthrough. Hey, Prophet! Yes, I am very close. And I think I'm about to beat this game if I remember correctly. I think Malik is the very last person to defeat. And of course, Bastila won't join me in the battle. She just wants to sit there and kneel and do her battle meditation because that's what she do. And I apologize, I'm gonna be slightly distracted. I have a package supposed to be delivered today. It was supposed to be delivered like 3.5 hours ago, but it's still in the truck, floating around my neck of the woods. And I got food on the way. So I'm gonna have to kinda keep a ear out and an eye out for that. Yeah, I don't need to keep that much of an ear out. Actually, I think I can probably beat this before they even remotely get close. So, how are you doing, Prophet? How's everything going? I'm doing pretty good. Kinda waiting for Miss Adventure to see if she's gonna join us because, she kinda scared the bejesus out of herself playing Alan Wake. It was rather amusing. Lots of little screams could be heard. Yeah, it was fun.
The mantle of Dark Lord from your feeble grasp. You made a mistake coming here, Revan. The Starforge fuels my command of the dark side. You are no match for me here, and this time you will not escape.
Oh, really? Semi-Dark Lord Malik. Alright, leaning back just right. Let's see. Surrender and the Jedi might show you mercy, says Slaughter in here. Nah, let's go with the mercy thing, because I'm all light side crap now.
Is that what you call it? You think stripping away your power and your identity was an act of mercy, Revan? I would rather die.
He seems, super intent on reminding me that I was Revan. Yeah, you can say from the dark side, Malik, it's cool, you know? I mean, we can't do anything about that jacked up jaw anymore, but whatevs.
Spoken like a true slave of the Jedi Code. Save your preaching, Revan. I will have none of it. You are an insignificant speck beneath my notice. I have surpassed you in every way and accomplished what you never could. I have unleashed the full potential of this Rakatan factory. You had no idea of the power within this place. Its very walls are alive with dark side energies. And now, my old master, I will let the Starforge itself destroy you.
Will you? Down some. Good lord, how many of these things can get created? Forge droid kitty. Your tail's in my way. It's right where my elbow wants to go. She doesn't care. how many are there? It's just on that side. Alright. they move. They aren't just placed droids. Cool. This is gonna be so much fun. Let's shock them. Let's shock at least one of them. Come on, now there you go. Yeah, they really don't. She doesn't care. She hates getting on camera, though. Like, you can see her ear in the corner, and that's about as far as she'll come. Cindy. Can I? Come on, camera. Nope. She, like, nah. Can't have none of that. How many of these were created? What the crap? Pretty sure I only saw like 8 of them created. I'm almost positive I have killed that many. Thank God for the easy combat stuff. Come on, UPS, get your shit together. Free experience, though. You know, I'll take it. That was only worth 50? I feel so gypped. Oh, the D's are really easy. Oh, it's still creating them! Jesus! Do I have to stop it from creating these things? Oh, I think I do. I think I do. Oh, okay. Stab myself with a healer. I just backed myself into a corner. I probably shouldn't have done that. I am not quite sure. Because it just keeps creating them, so I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do here other than just keep going through tons and tons of these robots? No, because it keeps creating the damn things. I want to leave combat. Let me come back down this way. Okay, I can't go back that way. Can I? Oh, B to disengage combat mode. There we go. Now I should be able to putz with these things. Aha! Spike bin! Computer spike. Alright. You guys need to seriously get out of my way. What? watch me be dead when I get back out. Disable generator, yes. Okay. So there's one down. As much as I love that free experience, that was really obnoxious. Uh-oh. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to disable all these, generators. Get out of my way, you stupid things! Because these spike bins aren't giving me enough spikes to do each one. Cause it's 8 computer spikes. I don't have enough. Well, balls. A black pug? I have a stub-tailed cat. She kind of looks like a pug. She's a little chunky like a pug. Okay, so we got... one computer spike, wow. I'm so fucked. I can't disable two of them. Yep. 7 spikes. All right, well, I can at least kill these relatively quickly. Yeah, she'll walk by once in a while. She'll never jump on the up on the desk though. She's too fat. And I think a little arthritic in the legs. Okay, so that is still... those are still producing. Can I loot these spike things anymore? Will they give me more spikes? They will give me more spikes. Hey! They give me spikes once in a while. It's nice. Yeah, that gave me 2. I should have enough now. I do have enough now. Alright, so I have 2 more to disable, and I need... ...15 more spikes to do it. Okay. It'd be nice if I could loot the dead droids for spikes, but apparently that's not gonna happen. You 2 droids are literally just gonna follow me around like lost frickin' puppies, aren't you? Are any little boxes down here? Nope. Seriously, you guys. Just gonna let him follow me around. They're my. It's. I'm a Jedi. It's like a Jedi and my droids. Like my puppies. Like Lassie. Oh, no more spikes there. Do I have to kill? I wonder if that's it. C droid and D droid. Okay. I have to kill the droid to get spikes to come out of their thing, maybe? I mean, that's easy enough. C droid was 75 points. 50. So I want to kill C droid first, because the D droids are stupidly easy. A. That's B. I don't want to engage. That's Seabin. I already got rid of C. Okay. Alright, that means that D-Bin will have two spikes in it now. Shouldn't have any. Nope. Okay. Yep. Alright, so if I kill a D-Droid, I get a spike from it. But I have to go to the bin for it. It's easy enough. Stop missing the really crappy droid, dude. Come on. So I'm just gonna go over here, wait for another droid to get created. Oh, that's not doing nearly. Your own weapons are not doing enough damage to you. Spikes. Five. No! Stop! Stop engaging! Use the computer! Damn you! Use the computer! Oh good, I have no spikes. Good. Not farming experience so much as farming spikes so I can destroy the little robot generator things. But yes, really? Now I can just talk to that droid? Just, I can't kill it? I'm dumb. The remains of my fellow Jedi. Nothing on that other body. He had no credits. To the factory. Alright, let me check on this food delivery real quick. Yeah, my nose itches. Why are you cooking a salad? Just throw some lettuce into a fucking bowl, man. And UPS still doesn't have their shit together. And I don't even know what the heck I'm getting. I just got a notification one day that said, "Hey, UPS World is shipping something to. Hi, Cindy. You want to come say hi to the camera? Come here, fat kitty. Oh, yeah, fat kitty. Yes, you're a fat kitty. You can't fit on my lap right there because I'm squished up against the desk. But I can make room for you here. Now you can lay on the corner. She doesn't care. And they won't talk to me because they know I'm talking to somebody. God forbid somebody else hear them meow. Hey there, Malik. How are you? I defeated your shitty droids.
Well done, Revan. I was certain the defenses of the Starforge would destroy you. But I see there is more of your old self in you than I expected. You are stronger than I thought. Stronger than you ever were during your reign as the Dark Lord. I did not think that was possible.
Of course it's possible. Because you're kind of a weak tit, and you didn't actually defeat me. You chickened out and attacked my ship while I was under attack.
I am tempted to try and capture you alive, Revan. Then I could break your will and bind you to me as my apprentice, as I did Bastila. You would be a far greater asset to me than even Bastila and her battle meditation, if I could control you. But is it worth the risk? Perhaps you are too powerful to be my apprentice. I betrayed you when I realized my own strength was greater than yours. In time, you might try to do the same to me.
I wouldn't say in time. I'm already stronger than you right now. I'm pretty sure if you bound me to you, I would just immediately stab you in the face.
Foolish words. The darkness and the light wage a constant war within you. The balance has tipped one way now, but it can easily be tipped back. Savior, conqueror, hero, villain, you are all things, Revan, and yet you are nothing. In the end, you belong to neither the light nor the darkness. You will forever stand alone.
I believe in the power of redemption!
Of course. What else do you have? Fate and destiny have conspired to keep you alive despite my best efforts. They have thrust you into the role of savior. We have been inexorably pushed to this final confrontation, Revan. I see now that this can only be settled when one of us destroys the other. Once again, we shall face each other in single combat, and the victor will decide the fate of the galaxy.
I'm pretty sure I'm going to win. But, you know, yeah, all talk, no chalk. Pretty much. Why do the bad guys always just want to chit-chat? Just always just have this diatribe of just nothing but blah, 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 blah. I'm gonna go ahead and shield up. Ow, you bastard! Just get rid of that life support pack, just in case. Yeah, I'm gonna need it here soon. Stab myself with that. Actually, I could do a lifesteal. Lifesteal his ass, damn it! No,
you continue to amaze me, Revan. If only you had been the one to uncover the true power of the Starforge, you might have become truly invincible. But you were a fool. All you saw was an enormous factory. All you ever imagined was an infinite fleet rolling forth to crush the Republic. You are blind, Revan. Blind and stupid.
What are you talking about? Is there a point to this?
The Starforge is more than just a space station. In some ways, it is like a living creature. It hungers, and it can feed on the dark side that is within all of us. Look around you, Revan. See the bodies? You should recognize them from the Academy. These are Jedi who fell when I attacked Dantooine. For all intents and purposes, dead. Except for one difference. I have made them become one with the Force. Instead, I have brought them here. The Starforge corrupts what remains of their power and transfers the dark taint to me.
The dark taint.
You cannot beat me, Revan. Not here on the Starforge. Not when I can draw upon the power of all these Jedi. And once you are beaten, I will do the same to you. You will be trapped in a terrible existence between life and death. Your power feeding me as I conquer the galaxy.
Hey, how's the game sound? Because I do have the volume turned down on my headset, so I'm not sure if it's picking up real well or not. Oh, I gotta kill the captive Jedis, don't I? The Jedi hangs in the grasp of the electrical field, but only by using the power of the Force could you free him. Oh, I gotta... God damn it. Oh, he is just kicking the snot out of me, isn't he? Are they gonna go suck the life out of another one? Shit. Sounds fine, okay. So he's using the dead Jedi to heal himself. Remember exactly what to do. I got that combat though. I'm gonna go over here. Stop! You're like a shit ton away from me. Well, why can't I use the damn Force? There we go. And heal up again. Go away, Revan. Or Malik. You rat bastard. I'm gonna get you to use up all your friggin' little life support things. Why are you not targeting Malik, you stupid ass? Can I do anything with these guys now? Grasp the electrical field, his soul has become one with the Force. Okay. Oh, he still has one left. Well, shitballs. can't do anything with that one. How many of these guys he got left? He used up that one. Stop with the damn electrical crap! Oh, that's the last one right there. I believe, anyway. Now you got nothing, dude. Now you got nothing but me and you. And I got a shit ton of healing stuff. Hey, life support. And shield. Final confrontation. Can I whirlwind him? Nope. Life support. Can I lightning him? Eh, it doesn't do great. I think I want to save my force points for the shield going on. Life support. I got plenty of things to heal me. Where's all your little tasty snacks? New Revan's like a Boy Scout. Coming prepared. You got nothing, Malak. You're about to get wrecked.
Impossible. I cannot be beaten. I am the Dark Lord of the Sith.
Well, you kinda just got beaten, didn't ya? Oh! Oh, which one? The first one's just a little jab, man. I'm gonna go with the jab.
Still spouting the wisdom of the Jedi, I see. Maybe there is more truth in their code than I ever believed. I cannot help but wonder, Revan, what would have happened had our positions been reversed? What if fate had decreed I would be captured by the Jedi? Could I return to the light as you did? If you had not led me down the dark path in the first place, what destiny would I have found?
Yep, I'm sorry I stirred you, but it's your own damn fault you continued on it.
I suppose you speak the truth. I alone must accept responsibility for my fate. I wanted to be master of the Sith and ruler of the galaxy. But that destiny was not mine, Revan. It might have been yours, perhaps. But never mine. And in the end, as the darkness takes me, I am nothing.
That was a really long death speech.
There you are. What happened?
He's dead. It's over. Oh my god, there was no way to turn him.
I don't think anyone actually expected that he could be redeemed. I'm surprised you would even think of trying. There's no time to celebrate just yet. I was able to use my battle meditation to allow the Republic to break through the Sith fleet. The capital ships are in bombardment range.
And that means we all have to get out of here right now before this entire complex comes down around our ears. Everyone else is already on the ship. Let's move.
Graphics. I know the graphics on this got an upgrade, but you couldn't get that much of an upgrade, but it still looks good. Yep, Mass Effect voices. Jennifer Hale as Bastila, and Courtney Taylor as Juani. Misadventure pointed this out last time I was playing when I was had Juani in my party that her battle cry is "I will be your doom," which sounds very much like Jax, "I will destroy you."
Admiral Dodonna, we've hit their main orbital stabilizers.
Everyone pull back. I don't want to lose any ships when that space station goes down. We did it, Vandar. The Sith are routed, and the Starforge destroyed.
But at what cost, Admiral? Where is the Ebon Hawk and her crew?
We're gonna come out at the last minute. For dramatic effect. Karth's just, like, timing it. From the explosion emerges the Ebon Hawk. Or not.
Karth, you made it.
We couldn't let you start the victory party without us, Admiral.
I'm sending an honor guard to escort you in. You'll be getting a hero's welcome when we all get home.
You have defeated Malak, destroyed the Starforge, and broken the spirit of the Sith. For this, I am proud to present you each with the Cross of Glory, the highest honor the Republic can bestow. From Coruscant to the farthest reaches of the Outer Rims, you will be known as the Saviors of the Republic.
On behalf of the Jedi Council, defenders of the galaxy, and sworn protectors of the Republic, I too would like to honor you for your actions. We Jedi now have another tale to weave into the grand history of our eternal order. The redemption of Revan, the prodigal knight. Wherever you go, you will be recognized as the saviors of the galaxy, the heroes of our age. But you must remain ever vigilant, for one day you may be called upon yet again to defend the glory of the Republic against the tyranny of the dark side. For this is the destiny of the Jedi.
Yay! Right. Let's see some stuffs here. Yep. Now I just gotta figure out, what game to play next. I'm almost thinking about doing Sid Meier's Pirates, if only because it's another original Xbox game. Or possibly Red Dead Redemption. Any suggestions? Sid Meier's Pirates was like one of the first semi-decent Caribbean style pirate game to come out. It is definitely dated, but then again, so is KOTOR. Think Pirates of the Caribbean without the cool graphics. I think either one would work for like my evening stream, since I'm only getting about an hour and a half, slightly less than 2 hours on some nights, so. Philip Darth Blahberry. A coin. Alright, we'll go heads, pirates, tails, Red Dead. Okay, Google. Flip a coin.
Okay. It's tails.
Tails. So Red Dead. All right. Luckily, it's already installed, so I'll have to wait for that. Ooh, Steve Blum is in this too. Who the hell is Steve Blum? If he was in this, does that mean Elizabeth was in this? Oh shit, Phil Amar was Gaddon Thek? And a few other folk, I didn't even know that. Yoon Ganda with Steve Blum. I don't think I ever met that person. Whoops. Oh, Mary Elizabeth was not in this.
Ooh.
Oh shit. I didn't realize Karth's voice was the voice of Kaidan. I usually kill Kaidan off, so I never hear his voice more than like an hour. Alright, so Jennifer Hale, Raphael Sabarge, Courtney Taylor, those were all in Mass Effect. How about Malik? Was he in Mass Effect? Nope. God, he doesn't have a lot of stuff under his belt. How about Candorus? Doesn't look like. Christopher Tabori? No. You always kill Ashley? I didn't mean to hit the mic there, sorry about that. I usually do a male Shep. So there's really no reason for me to keep Kaidan around. Zero reason. But, I'm thinking about doing another playthrough of the Mass Effect series, and in the first game, do a male Shep, romance Ashley, and then kill her in Viermeyer. That way there's no romance scene when I get to right before the last battle. And, then I can go into two with, as the distraught, emotionally broken Shepherd, and then romance Tally. Alright. I'm gonna exit this game. Which apparently you can't do from the main menu. Nope. Alright, go home. You guys are gonna see all my home shit. Don't care. I'm gonna go pop a disc in and be right back. I have to adjust some stuff on the fly. Because this is not a, This game screen's a little bit, bigger. It's a widescreen. Adjustment done there. I should probably update my game stuff too. Just do that via Stream Elements. actually, poop. Give me a second here. Dashboard. New tab. tab. This is an Xbox 360 game. Red Dead Redemption, day one. Update stream. Do I have to go offline and come back on for that to update correctly? Because I don't wanna. There. All right. Yep. I will just close Twitch and reopen it. Oh, I guess I can hit start, can I? Alert! You are not signed in! Well, sign me in, damn it. Yep, there's my Xbox Live information. Go to town, guys. Go to town. Alright, now it's correct. Check my UPS stuff again real quick. I swear to God, this UPS truck is just dancing around every other stop but mine. And he's actually been in my apartment complex twice today. Frickin' jerk. Oof. Oh, let's do it on normal, because I suck at shooting games. I am the worst. You are all going to be appalled. Hey, kitty. What was that? Hold on. We'll continue this in a second. Apologies. Hey, Cortana. Actually, I don't think Cortana can hear me. Ha ha ha. I assume that is you, Prophet. And not some other random person named Prophet. Yeah, it's fine. Oh, cool. Normal. Oh no, I didn't want to. No, I want to start over. I want to start a new game. My cats are staring hardcore at the door, so somebody's either walking up to it or somebody is going to walk up to it. It's like they just know. It's cool. Are you sure you want to start a new game? Yes. Because I'm all of like 10 minutes into this one. Friggin' mic is on that side. Sorry, guys. I didn't mean to cough right in your ears. I'm used to my mic being on my right side with my other headsets. Here's the one you think is a pug.
Bobby.
Prophet Roll called you a pug. She doesn't care.
You think, okay, you got food now?
Ninja Cat gets closer. Now you're not so ninja-like. Now you're meowing at me. I already fed you. I did finish KOTOR. Oh, I probably should have stopped the stream and restarted it anyways, just so I had this broke up into a different,
I'm grateful, Mrs. Bush, that they are finally bringing civilization to this savage land.
I could not agree with you more, my dear. My daddy settled this land, and I know he'll be looking down on us, pleased at how we helped the natives.
Yes, they've lost their land, but they've gained access to heaven.
Father, do you mean unless an innocent receives communion, they're destined to go to hell? It hardly seems fair.
What I mean to say, Jenny, is that there is a great deal of difference between an innocent and a savage.
I never thought that way.
Yes, they live like animals, but they're happier now.
Not only do people now have motor cars, Father, but I heard that pretty soon we will be able to fly.
No, only angels can fly, Jenny.
No, apparently people can fly. Didn't you hear? Out in Kansas, a man even got a car to fly.
I hardly think so, Jenny.
I don't know, I don't hate her. I just think she's really, really naive. And
apparently,
listening to this priest way too much.
Mr. Johns wants to run for governor. Which is why he's so concerned with cleaning up the state.
Nate Johns.
Yes.
His family is nothing but hillbilly trash that came here after the war. I don't want to be judgmental, but this state should not be ruled by such a disgusting family. A family without class.
Apparently. The Johns family have made a lot of money, and he has a lot of friends in politics.
Mrs. Bush, money isn't everything. There are many things that money cannot buy.
It seems that money can buy voters, though.
What you must remember, my dear, is that we have been brought here to spread the word. And the word and civilization, they are the same thing. They are the gifts. It is the opportunity we have, the chance to live among people who are decent and who do not kill each other. And who let you worship in peace.
It's so confusing, Father. Sometimes I find it impossible to make the distinction between a loving act and a hateful one. I mean, they often seem to be the same thing.
Yes, Jenny, it is confusing. But you only have to ask me if you need help.
Yes, because slaughtering natives is a loving act.
Armadillo.
Oh, I can walk around now. Go to the saloon.
Hello, sir. Oh, hello. Hey there. I don't feel too good.
You don't look too good. You're really wobbly, and please don't puke on me. Ladies.
You must be John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to gag you.
They ain't my friends, but pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out.
Thank you. Follow Jake to the horses. Or the guy that just passed out.
Mighty fine evening.
Well, here, let's mount up and hit the trail.
What if I wanted that horse?
Really?
Easy on the spurs now. We don't need to draw undue attention. You want to visit?
That's right.
Ain't taking nobody up to the fort in a long time. Strange place for a decent fella to want to visit, if you don't mind me saying.
Who said I was a decent fella?
It's been abandoned for years now. Folks say it was built during the Mexican War. What kinds of soldiers around back then?
Why'd they leave?
Well, I ain't entirely sure. I heard they had to go up north to fight Indians, or maybe they got tired of being soldiers and went looking for gold. You know how things is. So what are you doing up at the fort?
I'm looking for an old friend.
Well, like I says, you ain't gonna find many folk around those parts these days. Those you do find are about as sociable as an ulcerated back tooth. I mean, I ain't one to judge a man by the company he keeps, but...
Well, he ain't been friends for a long time.
Spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you can do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Thieves Landing. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hold up with.
I'm a married man, I'm afraid.
Ain't we all?
Come on, food. I'm getting hungry.
Giddy up. Yeah! So, Oh, it was the marshal who hired me. Lee Johnson. Do you know him?
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bugs asking for a guy. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah. You ain't very talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. It's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me. There's things you're better off not knowing.
I talk more, but they're having a conversation.
I tell you, Mr. Marston, those coyotes eat better than I do. Not far now, Mr. Marston. The fort's just over this hill.
This horse, the painted horse, is one of your favorites?
Oh, no.
Listen, mister. This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Well, yeah, you're technically typing. Approach Fort Mercer.
Come on.
It's more like a half horse. Not wrong being lazy. I'm lazy all the time, too.
Bill! Bill, I've come for you! Bill Williamson! Come out here right now!
Go away now, John. Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill.
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill, I implore you think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge! No more Dutch! And no more you. Implores. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Yeah, it is.
Well.
Oh. Poor John.
Yeah, these are some pretty good voice actors.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die, Mr.
Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
I was trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. You seen my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later and help me patrol the perimeter? You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind.
Yeah, I've never, never completed this game. Let me see the map real quick. Wrong way. So I made it to, is it Diaz Coronas? Is that the first bridge you get to cross? I made it into this area, I think, and just never got around to completing the game, cause school got in the way. Oh, was it a third of the way? Okay. That only took me forever and a day. So my food's like an hour late.
Of the living, I see.
Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
I sure can use an extra pair of hands around here. Let's see if we can get you back in the saddle.
Yes, let's, shall we? It's really too bad. I don't know, you can't romance anybody in this game because, can you?
There's the foreman's office. Also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws.
Totally romance this chick.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarlane.
Okay, let's see if you can still ride a horse.
Wait, people have actually said this is a quick game?
Let's make a tour of the ranch.
Did they literally just do the, story campaign? Like, no side missions at all?
Thank you.
wide as the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
Giddy up! And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished. Bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Never stole
change
a horse in my life.
Change is only good when it makes things better.
Borrowed them for a very long time. To four streams or 34 streams? Why are you not following this chick? I'm holding A.
Here we are, back at the house. Let's stop for a while before we head out on patrol.
You'll get no blame from me, Miss McFarlane.
Were they 24-hour streams? Well, I mean, KOTOR took me 20 days, and that was, like, less than a 40-hour game. Well, I don't want to run.
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Ma'am, getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house, and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
That's insane.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarlane.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time.
Is there a Mario Brothers, like...
Come on,
pipe thing I'm missing in this game? My horse is just like, let's go. Let's do this shit. You didn't hitch me right, jackass. Come on. My horse is kind of special.
Go!
Marston, I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team. God damn it, these rabbits are at it again. Come on, let's get rid of them once and for all.
All right, wait, stop. Stop, horse.
Get your rifle out. It's about time these little thieves met their maker.
I'm stuck on a fence and shit. Thank God it has auto aiming, because I'd be all over the place.
Let's get going. We've still got plenty of ground to cover.
It's 1 a.m. for you?
If it's not the rustlers stealing our cattle, it's the rabbits stealing our crops.
It ain't never easy living off the land like this. Maybe you should move to a big city, become a lady of leisure.
Was that a coyote? Get those pests before they scare the livestock. Oh, there. Good shooting, Mr. Marston.
Oh, still got one.
Come on.
You can actually handle a rifle.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe old Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarlane.
Here we are. Mr. Marston, makes me kind of happy I saved your life. Get some sleep and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarlane.
Alrighty.
I believe the town of Blackwater would benefit from some kind of parade.
Extra ammo from the trunk. Well, I mean, it's a salad, so I hope it's cold. Yeah, like the ETA is 6:55 to 7:05, and it's already 8 o'clock. Gonna be warm. God damn that gimpy ass lettuce. Yeah, probably. I think I'm gonna call the stream here. I'm gonna have to call this restaurant and find out what the hell's going on. If my food has been picked up yet or not. And if it hasn't, then I'm going to just cancel this order. And just go get some shit from McDonald's or some crap, probably. Save the game, because God knows I'll forget to do that, and I'll have to start all that shit over again. Save it there. Are you sure? Else? Well, hello there. I hope my food happens too. Alright, y'all. Thank you so much for stopping in and saying hey, and watching my horrible, horrible gameplay. You guys have a great night. And, or a really early morning, Prophet. I will see you guys, tomorrow morning. I will be streaming Dragon Age Origins. Going over to take care of the dwarven portion of that game. And, yeah. That'll be what I do tomorrow, and then maybe a little bit tomorrow evening. I might do some more Red Dead. Catch y'all later.
Bye.